Assalamualaikum. I'm Tanya Nordina. I'm from Indonesia, and I represent Heritage Amana. My mother is Malaysian, and I would like to ask you, what is your guideline in order for Malaysia and Indonesia to be able to build a strong relationship beyond 2020? Thank you.
Well, Malaysia's policy has always been to be friendly to everyone. We do not care what system they have, what ideologies they follow. We want to trade with them, and to trade with them, we have to be friendly with them. Malaysia is a trading nation. Its growth has been based on trade. So we need markets. We cannot afford to make enemies. So that is the future for us. Of course, there are people who create difficulties, but we have to tolerate that. That is why Malaysia is able to trade with almost 200 different countries and have benefited from the trade. And in the future, that will be our strategy in growing our country.
I'm a Chinese student studying in Malaysia. Recently, a comic book regarding the Belt and Road Initiative is making a lot of waves. So my question is, what's your take on China's Belt and Road Initiative? Is this a debt trap like the Western media claims, or is this a development platform like the Chinese government claims? And also, what role do you think this Belt and Road Initiative may play in the future of Malaysia, like beyond 2020 and also the Vision 2030? Thank you.
Malaysia has always regarded China as a friend, except for some periods in the early days of our independence when China was practicing communism, which could be exported to Malaysia. We don't want that. But now China has adopted a new policy, and this policy has benefited China very much because now China is one of the richest countries in the world. And rich countries make good markets. For Malaysia, there are opportunities for trading, and we want to continue with our good relations with China. But we support the idea of one belt, one road, but we have to find out exactly what this means. We cannot just, without proper studies, give 100% support to the idea. But in Malaysia, there are people of many different races, and their feeling about their racial feelings are still dominant. We don't want our people to think that we have now become, after becoming influenced by the West, we have now changed and have become influenced by China. I believe that China will agree influence over the whole world in the future. But for the moment, it is not for us to promote Chinese ideas and Chinese ideologies, but to find out how we can benefit from that. So that book, I think, is not good to influence the minds of our young people. The young people must understand the problems and the strategies and the policies of our own country first, so that when they come up against other people's strategies, they know their place. So we, as much as we didn't like the Western influence in our strategies and our schools, we do not want any other country to have undue influence over our young people. Thank you.